Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today, I will share the machine learning method called random forest. This is actually the similar method with decision tree that we have discussed in previous section. The random forest is created by Tin Kam Ho, a woman computer scientist at IBM Watson Health. Yes, because there is a lot of trees included in the method, so the name is random. The forest. Okay. Forest is contain a lot of trees. How to create the random forest? First, we have to create the bootstrap dataset. This is a small dataset come from the random original dataset. For example, the second row is capture in bootstrap dataset, and then the second from the first original dataset, and so on. So we have create for example four row, and then we create the simple decision tree, but without calculating the complex of entropy and gain information and etc. So we focus of a subset of this field or attribute or feature or column. Okay, many term for this table. And for example, we choose the good circular as the root, and then we consider another with aside good circular function, chest pain, backward, right, etc. We just choose, and then we go through until final decision, yes or no here, and do this for more simple decision trees. For example, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 trees. And how we use this forest to predict or to classify? Okay, this is only use of voting. For example, we choose three. In the first tree, the result is yes, but actually it's no. Yes. And the second tree is no, and third tree is no. So after we calculate for example four, three no, so the result is no because it's voting. Okay, let's try using a Google Colab. This is the Google Colab, and we use some import. Okay, we use the dataset load digits from scikit-learn. We just run this import, and there is what is the data inside. So we plot the 8 by 8 row and 8 column for this data, and the data is very small because 8 by 8 similar to 7 segment, I think, but this draw using the handwriting. There is 0, and this is another 0, 0, 0, and 1. another one, etc. Maybe there is seven, there is in the middle, and another seven, maybe there is no hand here. This is for I try to draw one. Oh, this is yeah. Try once. And okay, we create the random forest. So you have to import the random forest classifier, and then split the data for training and testing. Training and testing with its appropriate label. And we create the model. Also, we try to predict from the test data. And then we see the classification matrix. It is 0 to 9 digit. And you see that, for example, 0 is 100% accurate. And the other, for example, 8, it's maybe this difficult. It's just 94% accuracy. For example, we test using the third data here from the X test. You see the result is the 6. I try to open with IMSO, but we have to reset into original matrix A by 8 because the excess is 94. It is a vector, this is a matrix. So we see that. Okay, this is the 6. I think it is already correct. Okay, we try to another model. This is a first data. I try using not like this, it's 0, but there is an error. This is the 2. Okay, I think this is to correct. Now we use another data. I use Notepad to draw the test data. This is the function to pre-processing because we have to resize or reshape into 8 by 8 because our model needs 8 by 8 input or 64 input material factor. And another function is only to show the matrix. Okay, we use a Google Colab file to upload the data. For example, we open the two, and make sure that the data is uploaded. I have to refresh two, and this is we use the preprocessing function here, and then we use the model to predict. This model is from the training here, model.fit. It is a training function, and then we convert to scalar because this is vector, and we get the input. What is the number of the number two? Okay. And we compare whether the prediction is equal to the input. If correct, successful. It's not the same, unsuccessful. Okay, and then we use the dot image two here to show the test data here. Okay, we try. We have to input two, and the prediction is two. So this is the successful prediction. For example, we try another image. For example, I have 2 7. This is the first 7 with hand in the middle, and we calculate. We have to input actual number 7, and this is the successful prediction. And okay, we try to another image, the 7 without, yeah, without hand. Then we classify it. And the prediction is accurate. Okay, for example, I want to draw new. I have to use a dark background because in computer the black is 0 and white is maximum 255. So I have to convert. The background is not white but black. For example, I want to draw. This is, I think, the eight is the most, the worst result in, sorry. You see, this is the, actually the accuracy is 98%, but for the 8, 94. So I have to check using the worst result. Sorry. We have to upload 8. Okay. And we check the result. We input 8, and oh, there is an unsuccessful prediction because the result called this is 4, but actually is 8. Maybe I try to draw the. Okay, here more. Okay, it. I have to delete and upload again the new revision. Sorry, and then we classify. 8, which is wrong because after converting to 8-to-8 matrix, there is a, they said this is the 5, okay. There is an error. But if you want to get a better Accuracy, I suggest you to use GNN or another neural network basis. Okay. I think enough. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.